What was interesting was the fact that the intro that was given, they introduced me as a weather guy, you know, and you can always see the instrumentalists, their eyes roll. And I'm the same way when we have a guest conductor come into the Civic Orchestra of Kansas City, when they say a lawyer is going to be conducting, you kind of go, okay, what's this lawyer know about music? And I think they were the same way. It wasn't the Susan Boyle moment, like Britain's Got Talent, but I think after the first couple of measures, they saw the fact that I kind of know how to keep a beat. I will tell you, though, as soon as I heard the first chord from the choir, my eyes had seen the glory. Hearing that unmistakable Mormon Tabernacle Choir sound, my left leg started twitching. And it really took until the sopranos and altos came in with the Gloria, their first entrance, that it was almost like mom saying, it's okay, just have fun with it. And from that moment on, I was able to relax. But it was pretty stressful up until that time. I was rushing to get from the airport because I was flying in from a conference out in Portland, Oregon, and I wanted to bring my own baton, but I was so nervous about being late for this thing, and I put the baton on the passenger, or on the driver's side. Yeah, sat on it. So I had to use the regular conductor's baton, and I guess now I have to get a replacement pretty soon. This is the same arrangement I think everybody plays. Is the Wineski Battle Hymn of the Republic, and I think every church choir does it and every orchestra does it. It's a standard arrangement, so I actually did the piece from memory. I did not have a score. They mailed me a score beforehand that I could study, and so to prepare for this, people ask, what do? You stand in front of a mirror, you wave your arms, you listen to the piece in your mind, or you get a CD and try to follow along with it. I really didn't want to take too many chances with changes of tempo early on until I got more comfortable with them and they got more comfortable with me. And I'll tell you, when you have 350 voices this far away from you on the podium, there is a lag of sound. So when you're on your downbeat, it takes about a half a second for their voices to travel to you. And so it's really tough to keep the orchestra and the chorus together. But it was quite an experience, to say the least. This is the portion where it's just the orchestra playing one verse. So I think I finally decided, let me just try to slow them all down. See if they're all looking. And actually they were. After the first couple of measures, they were like, okay, we can follow him. We can keep our eyes on him. The toughest part is the rubato section. That's where it kind of flows and ebbs with the choir. And so you're just emoting to the choir and they're emoting back to you, so there's really no set tempo. You're just going with each and every syllable and hopefully they'll follow. And we did. And it's just amazing because it is such a familiar piece and it is such a familiar arrangement to hear my spin on it or to hear them following me is nothing like it. And people ask, is it powerful? More than anything, it's humbling that you hear this wall of music, you hear the sound, you have 350 voices from probably the most famous choir in America. I guess it's not by accident that Ronald Reagan calls this group America's Choir. They have an incredible, unmistakable sound. Then you put a professional orchestra in front of them. It's a heck of a combination. And it is humbling to have them look up to you for guidance. And it was an amazing experience. I know it was only for about 5 to 8 minutes, but it'll be one that's going to last for a long, long time memory-wise. Now what's happening is, since I've been up there for 4 or 5 minutes and the hard part is over with the choir, I decided to try to take a little more liberties with the ending, make it a little more dramatic, a little slower, and they followed. And by this time, I'm seeing not only smiles from the orchestra, like a couple folks looking up at me, And the choir is just beaming at this point in time, too. So this is the ending where it speeds up. You have to speed it up because otherwise the choir runs out of air to hold those notes that long. And then just the thunderous applause, the tapping of the bows on your stand. I mean, even smiles sprinkled about. It was pretty moving. It actually was, to the point of almost breaking down to tears, just because it's a cool piece of music. It has such a heritage with this country. It means so much this time of year. And to have them appreciate it was awfully nice.